got a sister as well, Miwa. Fantastic player.
Look at the work it's taking.
This is going to be the set pattern, isn't it, for this match? Just tell us a bit more about Ruben Phillips, because, you know, people maybe newer to the sport won't see that kind of style, this so-called defensive style.
So Ruben Phillips has chosen to be a defensive player, which means he'll go a little bit further back and chop. There is an element of safety to it, but to do it at this level against these level of attackers who hit the ball so hard, so difficult.
That's brilliant from him.
Look at this, just look at this. Yeah,
did bounce. Have a second bounce, but yeah.
2-1.
It's what's effective about the style is the fact that he's doing so many different things. He'll attack if there's an attacking opportunity. He'll twiddle sometimes to play it back on topspin. So you've got to play against so many different strokes, and you have to be very, very relaxed against Phillips, which is the trap that he sets.
And patient,
it's not easy,
right?
And patient. Recognizing the right moment to try and kill the point isn't an easy thing against Phillips.
Because you're also, he wants you to expend as much energy as possible and wait for you to make a mistake, lose your patience.
3-0.
It's all about trying to elicit an error out of you. There's a something in the crowd, a flash perhaps?
Flash, please.
But I think what you've also said about Phillips is that he's quite happy to then change it into an offensive game if he needs to, just to change things up.
3-0.
And when he does, when he swoops in.
But that takes you by surprise, right? That surprising element.
Yeah. Can come in the blink of an eye. He's lobbing here.
Ooh.
Well played from Haramoto. Still saying the flash is on.
Yeah, he's just getting disturbed by it. Now I think it's going right up to the person. Oh, getting earmarked. Last warning.
Three, five.
He's a fiery player in his own right, isn't he, Tomokazu Harimoto? I just feel some of that fire. He's not quite as vocal as perhaps I've seen him in the past. He seemed a bit more muted in the World Champs recently, didn't he, the World Team Champs?
Yeah, it's more selective, but at the same time, it's not like he's thinking about when to throw. It's just a reaction to a point. And first to 11, how hard it is and how important it is to win a point. I love it. I love the emotion. I love the showing. Who doesn't love a player who shows all this emotion? Some people think it's disrespectful because of the fact that table tennis is a sport that requires a lot of discipline, but
well,
there's nothing undisciplined
isn't it?
About.
Yeah, I'm quite happy to see that, actually.
Yeah, absolutely.
Well, the last time these two met three years ago, in the final of the WTT Star Contender in Doha, Harimoto won that 4-2. You're talking about attacking shots that he can play.
There you go. That serve, by the way, that backhand serve is so good. You can see he twiddles after it because he's serving with the inverted side to create more spin. And he needs to get that on the forehand for that loop. Haramoto keeps his nose in front here.
I remember last year, Hanemoto was completely outplayed by Quadri Aruna. He had absolutely no chance against the booming forehand of the Nigerian.
Very
different player, of course, he's facing here, Ruben Felix, but he just had no answers.
Part of that was because Hanemoto can sometimes get a bit stiff on his forehand. He's been really working on that forehand.
7-9.
Sometimes it looked like he didn't want to play it. You could get him into a blocking position quite easily, relatively speaking, at this level. So he's looking to make that his killer shot, not the backhand.
Okay.
8-9.
Superb on that forehand from Filos.
What a fade. Right down the line as well. Mesmerizing. Could he level?
That was
a spin on that.
Yeah. Two game points for Hanemoto.
I think some residual spin. Was this? Look at that.
Yeah.
Nine.
Three of the last 4 points have been on that forehand of his. Ruben Filus on attacking shots.
Wide serve. Wow.
11-9.
An offer. Points.
Talking of which, of course, there's going to be another smash. It's just been announced a few weeks ago. Saudi.
Love one.
It's happening at the start of May.
Two love.
You know, Fraser, he's been mixing it up really nicely, hasn't he, Filos?
That's his nature. That's what he does so well. Mixes it up more than anyone else in the world's top 100.
Three love.
And yet, he's really not played all that much this year. He's won six of the last eight here, Filos.
One, three.
Well, there's another German player, of course, who plays defensively, and that's in the women's game, Han Ying. And they're both
1-4
veterans of the game, shall we say.
Han Ying injured at the moment. That was a big blow for the German women at the World Team Champs. Time out here.
Yeah, she would have been key for them. German women who were bundled out earlier than they would have wanted. Time out being called.
Four, three.
Sorry, I did think there was going to be a timeout there. Hasn't been called.
My apologies.
4-4.
It's tough to say who's got more of an uphill battle. In terms of getting rid of the scoreboard, just imagining it.
5-4.
Well, I think we've got one now, have we?
Or Japan.
As in the youngsters coming through?
Yeah. They do have, of course, some very good players, but...
Kai Stumper and all that?
Yeah.
Well, they used a much younger team in 2022, the World Team Champs, that finished runners-up, that surprised many. Kai Stumper being one of those. But I take your point in terms of the grassroots and coming through.
Oh, it's so hard to lift that amount of backspin. You see the work in Tomokazu Haramoto's base, the transfer of his weight to lift that, and then he goes into the forehand because he wants a ball he's more accustomed to. Phyllis doesn't chop on the forehand.
Oh, opportunity seven, there perhaps.
Five.
He had him scrambling, Phyllis. By the way, Harimoto has only played prior to this five other defenders, and he's won four of those. So 80% win rate against defenders. A small sample size again. And right now he's got six of the last 8 points. Just that few defenders around in the men's game at this level.
There isn't really that many that
seven,
have been able to compete.
Six.
Because of how hard hitting the attackers at this level are. And
yeah.
You really have to be something special to survive.
Yeah.
You've had Phyllis, you've had Wang Yang, Giannis Panagiotis.
Yes.
Just to name a few from Europe.
Quickly advanced there, didn't he? Again. He anticipated that brilliantly, Ruben Phyllis. So well. And how he rushes back to the table at the right moments. They read it well.
Stunning. Absolutely beautiful from Ruben Phyllis there.
Look at that backhand. Couple of great
eight,
points from him.
Seven.
Dynamic. He's everywhere at once, isn't he?
Yeah.
Everywhere at once.
And he mixes it up, as you said. Different from a... That's three
seven,
quick points for him.
Nine.
From a traditional chopper, right? Who will just be only kind of doing that the whole time. That he wants to try and keep you thinking.
And it puts pressure on the attacker. You know your attack has to be good or your push has to be good.
Right.
Or we'll come in.
But that was important for Harimoto. Otherwise, Phyllis would have been on game point.
Ten.
Almost identical backhand to the one he played a little earlier. And he's now got two game points, Ruben Phyllis.
Twiddles. Look at that, it's like a tennis stroke.
Yeah.
It's like a Federer backhand, isn't it? How big
it is.
It
has got that wind up. Beautiful to watch.
Very different from Haramoto's.
Yeah. Who's now in a little bit of trouble here. And so Phyllis has level things here. Played very well so far.
That is emphatic.
One. Love.
Really nice.
Steps in Twiddles. Oh. So good. So good from Phyllis. How tactical Love. Can you be against Phyllis? Of course you can say, okay, I'm going to try and get him into the middle or wide and try and get him back. Pin him more into the forehand seems like a logical thing to do as well, but against all the different array of shots he gives you.
Oh! Okay.
Love.
Well, that went all his way. There's not much you can do about that.
Haramoto did well, but... Sprints in, Phyllis.
Some of the last eight have gone the way of Ruben Phyllis.
3-1.
I was looking to play that up till now.
Two.
Flawless backhand of his.
Got it!
going to be more positive, Hanamoto. He's lost a few points, so he's just going push, push, push.
Are you're saying that maybe less of that?
I think Hanamoto needs to try and engage more into the forehand of Phyllis than what he is. Because then it's his bread and butter. Then he's playing well. He'd play against a straight-out attacker. As I say, Phyllis doesn't push with the forehand. Doesn't chop with the forehand.
Four.
He's going to go into the middle and backhand. That's clever. Just try and make Phyllis have to make the irregular transitions.
Four in a row here for Harimoto. Yeah, it's a good run here for the five. Japanese player. Do you feel, you were saying, I think just as he was that comeback started, you were saying he needs to maybe play a bit more positive?
Yeah. I'm not going too big on the stroke, but play with more topspin. Just roll the ball over, get over the ball.
Six.
What about from the perspective of Phyllis now? What's he need to sort of...
Four.
Just keep mixing. Keep on mixing.
Yeah, it's been effective for him so far, hasn't it?
I think so. Maybe try and play a few third ball attacks. A few more.
Six, five.
And it's obvious that Hanamoto doesn't cover that wide forehand too well.
Expand on that a bit for us.
We've seen a few switches, haven't we, from Phyllis? Straight down the line. I mean, it's the tactic that Hanamoto likes to do to people. Switch them 1-1 on the table. And that's his very weakness. If you do that to him, he doesn't like it. Not many people do, but... In a fixed position, Hanamoto is very, very strong, but if you can try and get him wider, a little bit wider, you've got a chance.
5-8.
Does seem more mentally robust than when he was a little bit younger, Tomokazu Hanamoto. He's lost enough.
8-6.
And the key thing is he's learned to lose. Hanamoto. I think that's the first step in becoming a champion. You gotta know how to lose, you gotta be magnanimous in defeat. Oh. Scorches it.
8-7.
One away.
Now, just the 1 point in it.
Instantly.
8-0.
Read it so well, and look at that. Sweeps it up, that serve.
Yeah, he's been very good on the backhand today.
Eight, nine.
Tight finish to this third game.
Brilliant, absolutely brilliant there. The racket speed over that ball.
10-8.
Two game points here for Hanamoto.
Never need. Love.
Going for the long serve and attacking nicely there, Tomokazu Haramoto. Into the middle. Testing the in and out footwork of Phyllis. Serving long again.
One.
Survives that point. Tough to say what's an unforced error. Because the chops are such good quality. I mean, you can hear how quiet the contact is, how finely he's slicing it.
One, two.
Just because Haramoto's got time to attack it doesn't necessarily mean he should. Oh!
Way two. Beyond Haramoto. Oh. Excellent work from Phyllis.
Look at the feeling here from Phyllis. Wow. Catches the edge, but still, I'll take that every day of the week.
Now looking for that three, corner.
Two.
Again, Phyllis.
The serve drifts long at all. Instant punishment.
Yeah, again, this is one hanging in the balance. This fourth game. Phyllis, he's had the measure of Haramoto at times.
Four, three.
Turning into that gritty battle we kind of set this up to be. Imagined it to be.
Three, a
couple
five.
Of points there for Phyllis. Three in a row here for Phyllis. Not giving too much away, his coach, Roscoff. We haven't seen the traditional sort of big shots played by Haramoto against Phyllis standing way back. That's what people would normally expect from an attacker versus defender. Here we're seeing a little bit of it. He's done well to get it back, but he just left himself too exposed, didn't he?
Four.
It's Haramoto that managed to manoeuvre him around really well. He's doing it more. He's doing the first attack into forehand, then to backhand. Because Phyllis can't play a quality chop unless he's in position.
Right. As you said, it's all on the backhand, isn't it?
You go middle or you go wide as you can. Make it sound more easy than it is. But.
Well, that's that backhand that has normally been pretty reliable for him today.
Six. Oh.
And he's drawn level here, Haramoto.
Mate, it was no spin. He drove through wonderfully.
Right.
There's not any spin on the ball. That one that Phyllis gives you off the long pips will have a bit of kick, but it'll be basically float. So Haramoto's not trying to serve with too much spin. Oh, he's got the edge back.
Played that deep. Really deep on the
seven,
edge.
Six.
I don't think he's going to know how to feel there, Phyllis. Has he got the edge back?
He did. Did well.
But then missed that one.
Yeah, he did. That was the easier of the shots to play.
Six. Eight.
Didn't look too happy there, Phyllis.
Went for the moon lob.
Up by two here, Haramoto.
Yeah, pinpoint.
Six, nine.
strong performance here.
Well, that was very quick. We didn't get to see exactly what happened there. Four match points for Harimoto. So, Tomokazu Harimoto
to Tomokazu
through to the round of 13.